Is Power Rangers Dino Fury as good as we think it is? We're going to have a debate, argument, break this down. Let's talk about it. Hit that intro.
I can't do this on my own, because you know things ain't always sweet when you out here in these streets. But my morph will win it morph. I made a fake.
Yo, what's going on, everyone? It's your boy, Brosnan Brosnan, in the building. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the show. We love you guys. And this is one of those episodes that derived from the comments, from people kind of hating on Power Rangers Dino Fury and saying it's a bad season. And it kind of hurt a little, guys. It kind of cut a little deep because I love me some Power Rangers Dino Fury, all right? So I had to take a step back and argue with myself, is it as good as I think it is? So this is one of those arguments, and we're going to get into it, but if you like this content, make sure you hit that like, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell. You can also send us a super thanks right here on YouTube. Goes a long way, helps us on this daily video grind. Let's get into the video, guys. This is a topic that's going to be talked about for the next few years, is how good is Dino Fury? And it seems like every video I do about Dino Fury, you'll have one or two fans kind of hate on the season, but everyone else is just in love with it. So maybe we got like a 70, 80% love from the fan base, and let's say we have a 20, 30% hate or dislike, if you will. Maybe they don't hate it, they just don't like it. So How do we get there? Why do they love it so much? Why do they hate it so much or dislike it? We're going to talk about it and kind of see if we can answer the question. And that is Power Rangers Dino Fury as good as we think it is? All right. So let's start with just the characters. Okay. We'll just characters alone. I think that these characters are top tier between what we have gotten in the last 10 years from, you know, the Neo Saban era, even Beast Morphers. I really like the characters. I like the selections. I like the personalities. I get it. A lot of these actors, when they come on to Power Rangers, they all don't have a lot of in front of camera acting experience. Some of them do, and some of them are literally just like a walk-on, if you will, where they look the part, then kind of act a little bit, but it's more about the look, the energy, do they fit with the team? Because a lot of these lines are pretty simple. Like, I'm not saying acting is super easy, but at the same time, I'm not saying it's super hard if you put these guys in the right situations to succeed. And the way that they have made these characters and developed these characters, they have put the cast in the right position to do a good job playing the character. So I just wanted to put that out. When we're talking about the characters, I think the actors, actresses, cast members are doing a great job for what they're given, and they're actually given some good characters to play. Okay, just talking about the characters. Now when we want to talk about the storyline and within the character backstories and all that stuff, there is more going on in this one season of Dino Fury than there was between Dino Charge and Ninja Steel and Super Ninja Steel, all that stuff like combined. Between all of the mysteries, all of the questions, so many things that are unanswered going into season two. Like, usually there's one or two little things that you know you're gonna get, but in season two there is so much within storylines. So when we're talking character backstories and we're talking things like that, is amazing, because Power Rangers can get repetitive. But if you put little clips here, 2 minutes here, a minute here, that goes into a cool story, something from the past or the future, And something that I've appreciated lately that started with Beast Morphers and they're doing now, it's kind of becoming a seasonal thing, I hope, is doing these little small clips from old past seasons where we're teaching the Ranger history. It doesn't always have to be like a small clip show or anything like that. But in episode 21 of Power Rangers Dino Fury, they do a little clip show thing. Episode 14 of Dino Fury, the Lord Zedd episode, they went back and looked at clips on how to stop Lord Zedd or how to free the Rangers that were taken. You know what I'm saying, guys? So they used old information from the past and made it canon and made it all into the universe. That is amazing, because Seasons never did that with the Neo Saban, even the Disney era. They brought back, you know, a couple seasons. They'd always bring back the previous Disney season and stuff like that, and you had your big team up for the 15th anniversary, stuff like that. But they never really took that to the next level with teaching the Ranger history. That's one thing I absolutely love about this season, is they're not scared to talk about the past. They get into it, but they don't make the past 100% the show. And then we talk about team-ups and villains. Man, the villains are fun. You got an anti-hero right now and two misfits within Slither and Mucus. You've got all of these various different generals that be coming on like Boom Tower and getting destroyed. There's a villain for everybody, and that's what I like. They all have their own personalities. Is this the best villain crew ever? No, definitely not, but it sets it up for that next big villain. And the fact that you have Lord Zedd back, bringing back somebody big from Mighty Morphin, that's huge, man. And I know a lot of us are like, oh, bring back Rita, but Lord Zedd, it makes a lot of sense. And people are gonna hate about the voice. I didn't think the voice was that bad, honestly. But the suit is outrageously awesome. Like, that suit is fire. And the way that they had Lord Zedd picking up sporks and throwing them, and Void Knight throwing him to the ground, they made Lord Zedd a bad man again. And some of the lines, like the lines that he had, sounded like something Lord Zedd would say. Like he said, like, oh, the power ninnies are here or something like that. I'm like, oh my gosh, that's funny. I loved it. There were some really good points to this season that a lot of these other seasons haven't done, or they do a few things here and there, but Power Rangers Dino Fury connected everything together. And that's what's the difference between Dino Fury and a lot of these other seasons. Beast Morphers did a really good job with what they were giving. It was pretty much, you know, it was that first Hasbro season, but it was the handoff between like Saban. They kind of knew this was going to be their season, and they developed it. It was very good. I loved that season. Beast Morphers is my shiz, man. That's my jam. But Dino Fury, however, it feels more free reign, like they're allowed to do a little bit more, and all of the episodes connect, or most of them actually connect. Even the Halloween and the Christmas episode actually go into the storyline. Like, the Halloween episode's episode 14, but it's in between 13 and 15, and you can watch them together, and it makes sense. Same thing with the Christmas episode. They just put the Christmas episode last. And Void Knight was destroyed. They even said something about it. So, like, you can watch them all, and they all make sense. It doesn't spoil anything. It doesn't give anything away. It goes with the storyline. Yes, I know the Christmas episode, we know and wish that we found out how Slither and Mucus got out of the dark dimension. That is one thing that I could say. We know that they're there. They acknowledge the dark dimension, but they didn't acknowledge how they got out. So maybe they can talk about that again. But Power Rangers Dino Fury is one of the best seasons looking at it, okay? So we can go down the line. And this is just my opinion, but we're going to talk about it. So you got Beast Morphers, right? I think that this is one of the seasons that you could make an argument is better than Dino Fury. But just based on all the twists, the plot, the action, you can tell they're really like stepping it up. And now that they're on Netflix, the sky's the limit there. So let's just say Dino Fury is better than Beast Morphers, okay? So that's one. Then you got Power Rangers Ninja Steel. That's an automatic L for Ninja Steel. Like, they're going to lose that. I didn't like that season particularly, but I loved the cast. Like, I liked the suits. Like, that was one of those where I just thought it was going to be so much better than what it was. It was very corny, very cheesy to me. And Power Rangers is cheesy. I get it. But you can watch most of the episodes out of order. It just... nothing connected. And with Dino Fury, I feel like a lot of things connect and make you want to keep watching it. So that's a note in Ninja Steel. Then you got Dino Charge. It started out hot and really fizzled out early. It was decent. And I see why fans like Dino Charge, okay? So don't say I'm hating on Dino Charge, but Dino Fury over Dino Charge, all right? Then you got Mega Force, which was not awful. It was not awful, okay? I actually kind of liked Mega Force. I was not a huge hater like everybody else. Just the legendary battle made, like, because a lot of fans were upset about that episode, it just kind of made people think that the whole season sucked. And there was a lot of Saban filler episodes in there. So that is one that kind of, yeah, I thought they could have done better. And then you bring it to Samurai. And Samurai was special, man. Samurai was a special season, the more I look back. They did kind of take it back to the 90s, but they had Bolt there. Like, so they had a feel like they were trying to bring that back to that 90s Power Ranger vibe. And I really liked it. But comparing it to Dino Fury are two fully different spectrums. And some of these, it's on what you like, okay? Just on what you like, not on anything else. But in all honesty, I do love me some Samurai. But story plot-wise, I'm leaning towards Dino Fury. So just so we're arguing here, if we're having a conversation, Dino Fury is smack in a lot of these seasons. Now, I don't like to go too far back. I like to say the last 10 years, what season is stomping out Dino Fury? And I mean, and I just made an argument for a lot of these seasons too. I'm not killing any season. I guess I kind of killed the Ninja Steel season a little bit. But I don't think it was the cast fault. I just feel like it was Saban's last season and they weren't really putting the elbow grease into it and not really caring. And there was a lot of fart jokes, a lot of weird things going on there with Monty and was it Victor and Monty or whatever. Those guys were overhyped. I feel bad for those guys because they were just forced to be something that the fans didn't fully want. We could have a couple kids in the class. There's just not much development with those two, and they just felt forced. I didn't feel like they were ever helping the situation. Like, they just rewrote Bulk and Skull and made them kind of a little bit more annoying, as you will. Not saying they're annoying as people or anything, but just the way they wrote these characters were just so obnoxious, man. And it just didn't make any sense. You had these two buddies, a jock and a little nerd, and the nerd was his little minion, and it was just... it was so weird how that kind of worked out at the end of the day. I'm not a hater on Ninja Steel, but that's the one season that you can't really say is better than Dino Fury. And then a lot of these are just kind of what you like. I think when it does come to the the marketability and being able to sell toys and get this trending again, Dino Fury is one of those shows that has a lot of things that can bring you in. So that's kind of where I am with it. But I want to hear from you. Go crazy in the comments. Tell me, is Power Rangers as good as we think it is? Or is Power Rangers Dino Fury as good as we think it is? I'm going to go with the hell yeah. Two thumbs up. If I could give you more, I would. But I only got two thumbs. This is something that I want to talk about and get your opinion on. We love you guys. Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Peace.